Hey guys, welcome to another episode of KoS M Ts So. Actually made it to the beach, Mayaro beach, to try and do some surf fishing. But the rain, as soon as I reached, set up my lines, I didn't reach on the beach yet, rain started to pour. So I'm gonna give it about 10 minutes. If it doesn't stop, I'll just still go out in the rain. The footage won't be the best because, you know, the lens will get wet. But I'll still give it a try. I just want to give you a quick tour at a family friend's house where they let me stay for the day. It is a very nice place. It's a 5-bedroom, 3-bathroom. One of the bedrooms. See if I can get the light on. Pretty safe. Bathroom. You know, standard bathroom, beach bathrooms. Check it out. Just a quick tour. Switch off the light. I said it's a 5-bedroom, so a pretty big party could stay here. There's another bedroom there. A pretty nice kitchen. Stove. Fridge. I have some water in your fridge. That's not mine.
That's mine.
But my wife is cooking up a storm here, guys. This is all we have. So, here's what she's making. Chow it looks like. Chow, chow, chow. Check it out, without a doubt. Just continue on the top. Have some washroom there in case you're gonna wash off your clothes, I think. We have another bathroom here. Nice clean facilities, nice. Another toilet and bath there. This is the bathroom. Cool, that's the second bathroom. There's another bedroom there with a nice little dining area here. This is the other bedroom. You know, they're just doing some painting right now. So that's why things might be a little bit out of place. Another bathroom, newly tiled bathroom. Pretty comfortable. Really nice, check it out. Newly, just freshly tiled. Nice water pressure. You gotta worry about that. Come up on the beach. Rinse off in comfort. And although we don't really need it, they actually have. They're just painting over this room, but they have one air conditioned room. It's very cool, right? Cool right inside here right now. With the rain plus the air condition. So, I mean, what else could you ask for in a beach house? And as you can see, well, the rain is falling, but it's literally just off the beach. You're getting away from the immediate sea blast, but the beach is maybe 50 steps away. That's the beach right there. The reason I'm showing you this is I think they have it up for rent. If they do, you will be seeing this video. You can always send me a message if you might be interested in renting it. Rent by the day, rent by the weekend, rent by the week. It's a great place for a big family to come and spend a weekend. And I think the cost is pretty good as well. So, you know, if you want to, the house is still going, send me a message and I'll give you the contact information. It's a really nice house just off the beach. And we have chow making here. Can't wait to taste it. You know, my wife, she put about 6 pepper inside it. No pressure. So 15 minutes after, rain still falling, the chow finally mixing up a little bit here. Portugal, Putigal.
Putigal boy.
And cucumber. Tasting real good. Just setting up the surf rod combo I bought from Marquis in the sale. 9-foot tsunami. So I'm gonna make up a rig. Also have a couple other small rods there that I'm gonna fix up. And I reach out on the beach, I'll catch you back. Alright guys, I don't know if you can hear me in all this wind, but I'm on Mayaro beach. Just getting set up. First thing I'm gonna try is I'm gonna try to get some bait. Remember, I'm very new to surf fishing. So I'm gonna try my regular sabiki, which I use in other places. I'm gonna tip it with some store-bought shrimp. See if there's any luck with that. For sabiki, when you open it, you need to watch it carefully. Rod side, sinker side. Rod side will attach to your main line. So you get the swivel. 7 times. And when you pull it out of the pack, this breeze will kill me. You take it out of the pack, and you're supposed to carefully remove section by section, hook after hook. Take your time with it, especially if you're dealing with breeze. Here we go. There's supposed to be a swivel attached to it, but the swivel fell out. I was opening the package, I don't know how. So I'll just tie it back. As you saw before, rain was pouring for a good little while. Kinda ease up now. There we have it. Sabiki attached. I'm going to tip all of the hooks, some small pieces of shrimp, some store-bought shrimp, just cut into small pieces. But this is all new to me. I'm just gonna tip all of the hooks with the shrimp. This is going really strong. We don't want to cast too far with this rig. We might get some pressure with the bigger rig. So I'm just gonna drop this out. Hopefully we get some bait. These are the three fins here. If they choke you, you get a bad stick. So you have to dispose of them properly when you take them out. Small little river right here, let's toss it in there. Crabs might eat it. I'm gonna leg rod and cast him out. I mean, it's an unlucky day for him, but I need a bait for this. I'll show you the setup I have going on here. It's a running sinker, 4 ounce weight, and a circle hook. 4 ounce circle hook. So I'm gonna walk it as fast as possible and cast this out. Stick it right in my DIY rod holder. And wait for something to pull it down. So now the catfish can't really do anything because I took off his pinchers. I'm gonna stick him. Not through his head, his head is too hard. Just to the back of his tail right here. Not too far down. Just like that. Something could swallow him. Catch a bigger catfish, I'll be so happy. Definitely gonna carry that for one bucket. Any kind of fish that takes this, I'll be so happy. Well, it's my first time trying this kind of tactic. Brand new setup for all the monkeys yesterday. Gonna walk out. Not too far because my wife will get worried. We just about there. Decent enough cast in the wind. Not the best. But should be in the zone there. So we're just gonna set this onto the rod stand, the bucket rod stand. I'll keep fishing for bait. If I get a better bait, I'll switch it up. Hopefully this honks, wait, holds. Shit, the bucket holds. Rapid. The line is set up. If I get a better bait, I'll keep it. I won't change it right away, but I won't keep another catfish. I'll try to get a slightly better white bait. See? If I get a better bait, I might cast for the bigger one and hold it because I was just so far up on the beach. Kind of big belly on the line. How effective that is. If you guys have some tips for me, please comment below. Let me know. You should see the whole rod stand full and the rod in the water. Shark! The one if you see the shrimp flew off, but yeah, fine. Had to be a catfish. He's been really hard again. Which is not a catfish. But it is catfish number 2. I'll let this one go. Catfish number 2. I didn't show you guys just now, but I cut off this fin, that fin, and that fin. Those 3 fins, if they stick you, will be pain. So when you're handling them and using it for bait, etc., always good to cut it off. But this guy will be free. South homes. I don't know if you guys guys can tell from on the GoPro, but it looks like it's going to storm. I don't know how much longer I got to stay out here. We're going to try back for bait again. This week is showing some fish catches. Don't mind this catfish. The rod is in that boat right there. Something can take it and swim around with it. Something other than a catfish, come on. Oh, the rod is scared. This thing has a bus. Sabiki there too. Yep, I lost my sabiki. Just fell. Of any attack, so don't know what it was. False alarm. Sucks, man. I lost my sabiki. Well, that was our nice piece of excitement. There's no mind for nothing. The rod fell over. I thought it could have been a bite of fishing, you never know. Sabiki got caught on something out there. Lost the sabiki in the process. I don't know what it could be. Rain sand the pour back. I can't even see how much. Make up a trip tree hook banking setup. Don't try it again, I've given you in 10 minutes to ease up. Or 10 minutes for a shark to take my line. Either one, if not 12. Better call it a day. Catch a fish on the catfish this. I'll still consider it a success. I mean, though I was gonna catch wahoo or kingfish that I've been there fishing. Fish on the line is a fish on the line. So let's see what can happen. I wish the breeze could ease up a little bit. Rain is one thing, but this breeze is killing me. It's a catfish. Catfish number 3. Last thing I'm going to try after this, we're going to get next another species size catfish. Let's see if I can dig up a couple sand fleas, sea cockroaches, tattoo, whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to put it on the next rod and see if I can catch anything. I'll take about 15 minutes and see if I get any bites. Okay, no more bites of these shrimp. We're going to try them sand fleas for 15 minutes on the next rod. See if I get any bites. Okay, to catch sand fleas, I have my method as you stay at the shoreline. and you look for the V's when they take it down. If you see a V, you run towards it and you dig up the sand where it is, and you should get the sand flea. So you know this, scan this video and you can try it here. Let's see if I get two throughout one time. Let's see what happens. Alright, so the wave goes up. They should be coming up with the wave. And then they're looking for a place to dig down. When they're digging down, you might see the back of them. As they're going down, you'll see like a V where the water is shaping down. Once you see that, run in, start a dig. Then they chip. That was a chip. Like chip. Got him. So this is what we're trying to get. You can see down the camera. Sand flea. So that's one. Just want to get one more. Control our line. I caught this one over here. Basically, these are the two sand fleas. Just dug them up as you saw. Don't use them for bait, they should be pretty good bait. Once they flip over like this, they're pretty docile, but if you put them the next week, take a look how fast they dig down. Dig down the main. So, once you catch them, keep them away from the sand. I'm gonna hook them up now and see what happens. So there we have these two sand fleas on the line. One and two. I'm gonna try this. I'll give it a 15 minutes. See if any luck. So let's go and throw back out. I'll try one more. I think I need to grab a sinkers. Line is floating down the road. So I'll throw back out the sand, please. Sea cockroach. The rain starting to come back down. So I'm trying this for about, give it a 10 minutes again. Brutal condition, brutal. Alright guys, we try, but this rain does not give me a chance at all. And the breeze. So we're going to rack up there. We'll try back on next day. Normally sometimes this water is be as calm as could be. Today was just pressure. That's how fishing is go sometimes. So that's still living real good. I don't think he will survive, but catfish real strong. Alright guys, you see I tried for about 2 hours. This rain just doesn't want to stop. I know there wasn't much action, only 3 catfish. But the point is, that's fishing. Sometimes you catch, sometimes you don't catch. I'll definitely come back and try. Sometimes this water is as calm as can be. Yesterday was just a bad day. So guys, I appreciate the view. If you're watching the end, thanks for watching. Fish on.